Galileo, the most famous scientist in the world before modern times. Everyone knows that the Christian Church persecuted Galileo for his scientific discoveries. The trouble is that what everyone knows is wrong.
When this controversy began, the controversy over Copernicanism began, was shortly after Galileo had made some interesting discoveries with his telescope. Things such as the surface of the moon with its unevenness, sunspots, phases of Venus, moons of Jupiter.
This is the importance of the new technology. Two little lenses in a tube and the universe becomes a different place. The moon was not a polished silvery ball. It was rough and had mountains and pits, later called craters, and all sorts of variegated phenomena. Jupiter had four little moons going around it. So clearly the Earth was not the only sole source of rotation in the universe. Jupiter was a source of rotation. Venus showed phases, showing that it clearly went round the sun. And also, too, look at the Milky Way. Look at the stars you see on a dark night. Look at them through a telescope and you see thousands and thousands more, even through the most feeble telescope, as you can do today to do, let's say, a cheap pair of binoculars or something like that.
Why did Galileo's discoveries matter?
Well, they were important because, in one way or another, they all had some implications for whether or not the system of Aristotle and Ptolemy from ancient Greece was accurate. For example, according to Aristotle, the heavenly bodies are all perfect spherical objects. Galileo found that the moon is a rough and uneven object like the Earth. That went against a classical concept. No direct assault on an idea of the Church in that. The reason the Church came into this was because there are a few verses in the Bible, in the Old Testament, that speak either of the Earth as if it were at rest and permanently fixed, or speak of the sun as if it's in motion around the earth. An example of this is in Ecclesiastes, where you have the statement about the sun also rises and the sun goes down. Ernest Hemingway made the title of a novel out of that. It speaks as if the sun is moving across the sky. And to the ordinary person, of course, the sun is moving across the sky. That's what it looks like. We still speak of the sun rising and setting today without anyone getting caught up in a conceptual difficulty. But the Church was committed to interpreting the Bible without disagreeing or contradicting a consensus which may have been reached by the early church writers, the so-called patristics. The Roman Catholic Church in particular tied itself to that in the Council of Trent, dealing with Protestant heresies in the mid-16th century. The Council of Trent ruled that it was inappropriate to interpret the scripture in a way that was contrary to the unanimous consensus of the church fathers, if there had been one, although they were quick to add that this had to be a matter of faith and morals, that this was not applicable broadly, but specifically to areas of faith and morals. Galileo himself put it this way. He had great admiration for those Copernicans who have, in his words, through sheer force of intellect, done such violence to their own senses as to prefer what reason told them over that which sensible experience plainly showed to the contrary, end quote. So even Galileo understood full well that it made perfect sense for people not to accept the Copernican view at the time. And indeed there were, between the time Copernicus's book was printed in 1543 and until shortly after Galileo's book on the Starry Messenger was printed in 1610, for all that period of almost 70 years, we only know of about a dozen people in the whole world who thought Copernicus was right. That's an astonishingly small number for such a long period of time. So the burden of proof was definitely on those who wanted to proclaim that the Earth moved. And the Church encouraged Copernicus to publish his ideas. They did not really create a great deal of controversy until the time of Galileo, when this pushy scientist began to try to persuade the Church that he had more evidence than he really had for the Copernican system.
Using his telescope, Galileo saw far more stars than you can see with the naked eye. He saw the moons of Jupiter, the phases of Venus, sunspots, and the rough surface of our own moon. Galileo's discoveries show that the heavens weren't perfect and unchanging, as the ancients had thought. This contradicted current scientific beliefs, not religious beliefs. And when he said that the Earth goes round the Sun rather than the Sun going round the Earth, well, there just wasn't the clear scientific evidence to prove that. The Galileo affair never was a simple conflict between science and faith. It was a conflict within science, and at the time the facts didn't seem to be on Galileo's side. But if it wasn't a conflict with faith, we'll ask next time, why did Galileo get in trouble?